Hello everybody and welcome to another Victoria 2 money lesson on the Iron Workshop. In this lesson, we'll be learning how to create a whole new country in the game. And of course, we will be recreating the amazing, incredible nation of Bikini Bottom. Let's roll the intro and get to it. Before we begin, a couple of things that I need to say. First of all, you will need a graphic editor for the purpose of this lesson. Now, I will be using paint.net, but if you have another graphic editor that you're more comfortable with, you can also use that. Just make sure that it outputs the file format properly. Another thing that you should do before you proceed with this lesson is change some settings in Victoria 2. First of all, you will need to start it in window mode. That will make things much easier for you. So to do that, go to Option, select the resolution that you want your game to be in, select window mode, and it's probably also a good idea to raise the refresh rate since the game has a tendency to put it down back to 59, which is really low and isn't actually very good for your eyes, so it's best to raise that as well, if possible. Now, working in window mode will allow us to switch back between the editors, between the graphic and the Notepad++ editors, and have the game in there still working, which will make things much easier for us. All right. Now, I will have links both to the download of Notepad++ and paint.net in the description of this video. So go ahead, check them out and download these if you want to use them. Now, there are six main steps in creating a new country in Victoria 2. So first of all, you will need to create a mod file. I have a separate video for that, so go ahead and do that before you proceed with this lesson. Second, we will need to create our folder and file structure, which will tell the game where the files of our mod are located. Third, we need to create our country flags. Your country will not work if the flags are not properly set. Next, we'll need to assign some territory to our country, but this is optional. For example, you can have your country as a releasable country if you don't assign it any territory, but you do give it some states in certain provinces. Next, we'll be assigning armies to our new nation. That is also optional. Obviously, if your country is a releasable one, then it doesn't have any armies at the beginning of the game, or maybe you don't want it to have an army. That's totally fine as well. But we will be learning how to assign a starting army to our new nation. And the last step will be to test all of this in the game. As you work on this, you can actually test these things one by one. For example, create the flags, make sure that they work. That is actually highly recommendable, but not something that I want to do in this lesson, because that will just prolong it unnecessary. So we'll start this lesson with step number two. I'm assuming that you already did step one with the video that I have a link to in the upper right corner of the screen. And we'll go ahead and create our folder and file structure. All right, so in this step, we'll be creating our folder and file structure, basically telling the game which file to use, where these files are. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to open two folders simultaneously. The first one is going to be the vanilla or the core game folder where Victoria 2 files are located. And the second folder is going to be the mod folder, and specifically the folder of our new mod. In this case, I called it country mod. It is possible that you named it something different. Just make sure to put all your files in there and put them correctly. I will say this, while creating this video, I actually done some mistakes myself, and I sometimes put files inside of the wrong folders, and then I wondered why things are not working. So that could definitely happen to you as well. If that happens, that's fine. Mistakes are part of the process. Just make sure to go over these things a couple of times, just to make sure that you have everything in the correct folders. And I might actually make mistakes while doing this video. As I said, it's all part of the process. All right, so what folders do we need for our new country? The first folder that we need is the common folder. So I'm going to go ahead and create that one. Now inside of the common folder, there are a couple of files and folders that we need as well. We need the countries file and the country colors file. So I'm going to copy both of these into my common folder. in my mod. Next, we have a folder called countries. So I'm going to go ahead and create this folder as well. As you can see, I named it incorrectly. So one of the things that you could do to avoid these mistakes is just copying the names and putting them here to make sure that everything is named correctly. So inside of here, I will need to create the entry for my new country. Now, the best thing to do is to take an existing file. For example, you can take the first file called Abu Dhabi and just put it in your mod and then just rename it. So we will rename it obviously to Bikini Bottom. Just like this, excellent. Now, the next folder that I need is the GFX folder. So I will go ahead and create that one. It's the folder right over here. And from inside this folder, we will need the flags folder. So let's go ahead and do that. Flags. And in this folder, we'll be putting the flags of our new country. Now, all countries in the game have one standard flag, which is just the three-letter designation of that country, the country tag. And also they have four files for the four different ideologies in the game. Now, if you have more ideologies, then obviously you will need to create more flags, but we're just following the standard procedure here. So I'm going to take all of these five files. As you can see, they're all ABU, ABU, ABU. So I'm going to grab these files, I'm going to paste them in here, and they are now part of our mod. Now, the next thing that we're going to do is to assign a tag for our country, right? So the game needs a three-letter designation for our country. Now, since our country is Bikini Bottom, then I'm just be using the BKB tag, just like this. And I'm going to apply it to all of these files. I'm going to change the names just like that. Now, in case you're wondering, how am I renaming the files without going right-click rename? If you select the file and you press the F2 button on your keyboard, that will put you in rename mode. And that is how you can do that. There we go, almost done, BKB, excellent. So these are the flags for our country. Now, obviously they still don't look the way we need them to look, but that is fine. We're not finished with creating our folder and file structure just yet. So let's go back. And an additional folder that we will need from here is the history folder. So I'm going to go ahead and create that one as well. Inside of the history folder, there's a folder called countries. So we will need that one. We will also need the provinces folder. And we will need the units folder. Excellent, just like this. Now from the countries folder, I'm just going to grab one of these files. Let's say Abu Dhabi. And I'm going to put it in here. And of course, I will rename it to my tag that I created, Bikini Bottom. Excellent. From the provinces, I'm going to need the province file. Now, if you know how to do this, that's fine, but if not, we'll come back to this step a bit later. So right now, let's skip that and go ahead to the units folder. And from here, I'm just going to once again grab one of these and just rename it to our country tag, just like that. The next folder we will need is the localization folder. Now, this is a bit of a complicated name, so I'm just going to copy it like this, excellent. And in here, what I'm going to do, I'm going to grab one of these files. I'm going to copy it over here and I'm going to change it to Bikini Bottom, just like that. Excellent. All right, so now that we have all the required folders and files, we can go ahead and start changing them to fit our new country. So let's go ahead and start changing these files one by one. We'll go into the common folder. We'll open countries, Bikini Bottom. Now, there are a couple of things that you can change in here, but we'll just be focusing on the basics. I'm not going to go too in-depth into how you can customize the nation. That is definitely something you can take your time with and make your nation really unique, but this lesson is only supposed to give you the basics. So one of the things that we need to change here is the color. So we'll need to assign a unique color to our country. So to do that, I'm going to open paint.net, or you can open whatever it is you're using. And I'm going to be using this color wheel in here to select the color that I want for my country. Now, this is a good color that I actually like. So I'm going to press here on the more button, and that will give me the RGB values. So what the game expects you to put in here are the values of these RGB colors. Now, RGB stands for red, green, and blue. So basically it's three colors, and when you combine them in different ways, they create the color that you want. So I'm going to copy the values from here over here, and they go from left to right. This is R, the red, this is G, the green, and this is B, the blue. So let's go ahead and do that. So my red is 153. My green is 244 and my blue is 255. Excellent. So we now have the color of our country. This is the graphical culture. So whenever you have unit sprites on the map, how these units will look. In this case, they will look Middle Eastern, and I actually don't want that. I want to change that. So let's go ahead and open the Victoria 2 folder. We'll go to Common. And inside of this folder, you have a file called Graphical Culture Types. So in here, you have all of the possible graphics listed. Now, what I'm going to do here, I'm going to select one of these. We'll just give it the generic one. Obviously, if you want it to be anything else, you can just choose to use that. So we'll be using the generic in this case. And now we have a list of all the parties that my country will contain, as well as unit names. You can keep these names, you can change them, doesn't really matter, especially not for the purpose of this lesson, so I will be keeping this. But one thing that I will be changing is the three letter tags in here, because we wanted to refer to our country, Bikini Bottom. So I'm going to do the following. I'm going to select ABU in this case. I'm going to press Control plus F on my keyboard. That will open the Find menu. And in here, I'm going to go to replace, and I'm going to replace ABU with BKB, the country tag that I have assigned to Bikini Bottom. Now, one thing that I want to select is match case. That will make sure that only where ABU is in capital letters, it will change it. And I'm going to press the replace all button. And as you can see now, everywhere where it said ABU, it now says BKB. So this will give the name to our political parties of our new country. All right, now let's proceed. So the next file that we need to edit is the countries file. Now this file lists all the countries that are available in the game. So we will need to add our new country in here. It's best to add your new country at the bottom of the file, right before the dynamic tags. These dynamic tags are used for revolts, for revolting nations, and for rebels. So we won't be changing them. So I will be adding my new country right here below Jean Mayen. I'm going to copy this line. I'm going to paste it. I will give it the tag of our new country. And in here, it's very important that you give it the name of the country's file as it is named in the country's folder, right? So in here, if it's called Bikini Bottom, the name has to be the same in here. If it's not, things will not work properly. All right, so we've edited this, so we can save the file. Great. Now the game knows that there's another country called Bikini Bottom, and it's expected to do something with it. And one of the last files that we need to edit inside of the common folder is country colors. This file determines what will be the color of your country on the map. Now, you might say, but didn't we already do that in here? We did, and to be honest, I'm not sure that this function actually does anything, but I do like to keep my files consistent, and that is why we've made this addition in here anyway, but you do have to do it in this file in order for it to actually properly show up. I'm going to copy an existing entry. Just going to paste it. And in here, I will type bikini bottom. And in here, the three-letter tag of our country. And I'm going to copy this RGB code that we've already assigned. I'm going to put it in here, just like this. Now, the color of your country will depend on the color 1 section in here. I'm not actually sure what color 2 and color 3 do. If you have any idea what are these responsible for, please let me know in the comments to this video, and I will make sure to add a comment that explains that. All right, so this should do it. Now let's see what else we have to edit in here. Next, we have the history folder. We'll take care of the GFX folder very soon, just not yet. So let's go into the history folder. And inside of that, we have countries. And let's go ahead and open this. So the first thing that we need to assign here is the capital of our country. We will be taking care of that very soon, but just not yet. Next, we have the culture of our country and religion. So we can definitely change these things as well. In order to find the list of all possible cultures, you can go to Victoria 2, Common. And inside of here, you'll have a file called cultures. So all you need to do is to give it the culture that you want to be used. Let's say that I want Bikini Bottom to be of a Caribbean culture. So let's see if I can find that. Caribbean. Yes, I think it's this one. So I'm going to go ahead and put it in here. My primary culture is going to be this. Now I also want to change the religion, right? Let's go to religion. And in here we have all of our religions. We'll make them pagan, I think. Yeah, that makes total sense. I don't think there's any official religion in Bikini Bottom. Now, the government, we could keep it absolute monarchy. If you want to change it, then once again, you have a file called here governments, and you can use one of these. It can be an absolute monarchy, HMS government, whatever you want it to be. Again, not really critical for the purpose of this lesson. Now, the ruling party is going to be Bikini Bottom Conservative. Okay, let's go ahead and save that. And obviously, you can change a lot of other things in here as well. One last thing that I do want to change is my OOB file. The OOB file is the file that contains all the armies and tells the game where to put them on the map. So, of course, we will change it as well to BKB OOB. And we'll see what we're going to be doing with this file later on. Okay, so one more thing that we have to do in here, we obviously have to change the name, right? Because it's not Abu Dhabi, it's Bikini Bottom. So let's go ahead and change that, Bikini Bottom, just like this. We'll just close this file here and reopen it, okay? So let's see what else we have in here. We have provinces and we have units. So let's go ahead and take care of the units. So in here we have the OOB file that I talked about before. And in here we have armies of Bikini Bottom. Okay, Bikini. Yes, and we'll just call it, SpongeBob Regiment. SpongeBob Regiment. Yeah, that should do it. Okay, we'll take care of the location and home very soon, just not yet. Now, let's see what else we've got in here. That is not the folder that I need. Okay. So we have provinces. We'll be taking care of provinces as well very soon. And we have localization. Okay, so let's go into the localization file. And in here, as you can see, we have quite a lot of stuff. But I'm going to get rid of most of this. So I'm going to select everything and just remove it. So what we want to put in this file is first of all the name of our country, the adjective of our country, and also the names of the political parties, right? So I'm going to type here BKB, semicolon, then I'm going to type the name of my country, Bikini Bottom, and another semicolon. Now I'm going to put an X in here, and I'm going to type semicolons four times, 1, 2, 3, 4, just like that. Now, the reason that you do this is, first of all, in here, the semicolon tells the game that this is the end of this entry for the English localization. The X tells it that you don't have any further localizations, and these four semicolons, I'm not sure if they're necessary, but they basically tell the game that this is the end of the localization entry. The next thing that I'm going to do, I'm just going to copy this thing, put it in here, and here at the beginning, I'm going to add underscore ADJ, and this will be the adjective of our country. So we'll just call it Bikini Bottomer, something like this. Yes. Okay. Next, we will need the entries for our political parties. So we do actually have it in one of these files. Let me just find it. Where did we put it? I think we have it in here. Yes. So Bikini Bottom Conservative. And we'll just call it something like the Bikini Bottom Council, right? Something like that. Let's just do it like this. Okay. Now, obviously, if you want localization for all the political parties in your country, then you will need to put localization for all of them. I'm not going to be doing it right now, just not to make this lesson too tedious. All right, so we basically edited most of the files that we need. Let's just make sure. And we need to proceed to the next step, which is to create our country flags. Okay, so let's go ahead and create our country flags. They are located in GFX flags. So I'm going to grab all of these flags. I'm going to drag them into paint.net. And we'll be opening them. Excellent. Now, obviously, it's quite natural if you want to have different flags for the different ideologies, and you can definitely go ahead and do that. I will just show you how to make one of these work, and you can obviously repeat the process to create other flags. All they're depending on is the name of the flag, right? So in here, we can see that for the monarchy, we have this, for republic, we have this, and so on and so forth. Now, I already have a flag for Bikini Bottom from my previous lesson. So I'm going to use that, open. And now I'm going to use the rectangle. I'm going to select everything, copy it, paste it in here, keep canvas size. Let's just make it a bit smaller, and I'm going to resize it to be like this. Let's zoom back in. Right, so something like this, more or less centered. Very good. Okay, so now I'm just going to copy this, and I'm going to apply it for all of these, and I'm going to press the save button. You can just keep these settings as they are, and once again, save. Excellent. So now we have our country flags. Okay, not so difficult. Very good. And now we can proceed to the next step, and that is to assign territory to our country. As I said before, it's optional if you're not creating a releasable nation. Assigning territory for a country in Victoria 2 is a bit complex, but once you understand it, you can definitely speed up the process, and after doing it a couple of times, it will really seem easy to you. So the first thing that we need to do is to decide where our country will be located. So let's open the game and see where we want our country. Now, for the purpose of this lesson, I want to take something simple. I want to take just one province. And as we've seen at the beginning of the lesson, that's going to be Bermuda. So Bermuda is going to be the territory where my country is located, and it will also be the capital of my country. So if we look at our country file in here, in history, let me just show you which file we're talking about. History, countries, Bikini Bottom. The first thing that we need to do here is to assign a capital. Now the capital is designated by the province number. Each province in the game has its own unique number, and that is how the game tells them apart. So we'll need to tell the game what is the province number of Bermuda. Now in order to find that, what you can do, you need to go into the game. You then need to open the console by pressing the tilde key. That's the key right to the left of the number one key. And once you've opened the console, you will need to type the following command, prov id, and press enter. What this will do, it will put the ID number of every province that you hover over with your mouse in the tooltip that is displayed to the right. As you can see here, the province ID for Bermuda is 203. So I'm going to change my capital here to 203. Excellent. Now, this is not enough. Just because Bermuda is designated as the capital of Bikini Bottom doesn't mean that the game will automatically grant our new country this province. We need to tell the game that our country owns that province, right? So in order to do that, we'll go into our history folder, provinces, and now we'll need to copy the relevant province file. So let's go ahead into Victoria 2, history, provinces, and in here we'll need to locate the Bermuda file. So let's first of all try by searching the number. All right, and as you can see in here, there's a file called 203 Bermuda. So I'm going to right click, open file location. And as you can see, this file is located inside of provinces and then another folder called Caribbean. So I will need to create that folder as well inside of provinces. So let's go ahead and do that, Caribbean. And I'm going to put this file in here. Just like that. Now I'm going to open it. And in here, there are a couple of things that we can change. This is the owner of the province, who owns it at the beginning of the game, when the game starts, who is the owner. And of course, I want Bikini Bottom to own it. Now, on top of owning Bermuda, I also want Bermuda to be a core of Bikini Bottom. So I'm going to add another line in here. Add underscore core, and I'll put the tag of my country, just like this. And of course, I want Bikini Bottom to also be the controller of this province. And there are other parameters in here, like trade goods, life rating. It's not a colonial province, right? We're not going to have it as a colonial province, so I'm going to remove this line, just like this. And I'm going to save it. So now the game knows that Bermuda is owned, controlled, and is a core of Bikini Bottom. All right, so we can now proceed to step number 5, assigning armies to our new country. So assigning an army to our country is much easier now that we know how to find out the IDs of provinces. And in this case, it's actually going to be very easy. So let's go ahead and open our file. If you remember before, we had a file called BKB underscore OOB. And in here, we've created our army. But the game needed to know where this army is positioned. Now, we know that we want our army to be positioned in Bermuda. And the ID for Bermuda is 203. So that is exactly what I'm going to do. 203, just like that. Our army file is finished. Now, it's very important to make sure that this OOB file is inside of your country history file. Otherwise, your armies will not show up on the map. In here, it seems okay. So we can now continue and actually test this thing in the game and see if it works. All right, so now let's go ahead and see if our new country works properly in the game. If you had the game running up until now, please note that unfortunately, Victoria 2 is one of those older games, so a lot of things don't actually update in-game while you're running it. You will need to do a lot of restarts in order for things to refresh and actually show up. So I'm going to close the game and I'm going to start it once more. Make sure to select your mod in the launcher and let's see what we got. All right, so as you can see, we have now the country of Bikini Bottom in the game. We have our Bikini Bottom console. Everything seems to be working. We even have a small army here, which is ready to defend the nation with the SpongeBob regiment. So hopefully things worked out fine for you as they did for me. If something doesn't work out, please let me know in the comments and I will do my best to help you. If you found this lesson helpful, please press the like button in order to let other people see how easy it is to create a new nation in Victoria 2. Subscribe to the channel to be notified of new episodes once they're released. Thank you very much for watching, and I will see you in the next video, lesson, or tutorial on the Irish. Bye-bye. Thanks for watching this video. If you enjoyed it, give it a like. The algorithm and me will be very happy. Here are more videos I make. If you like my stuff, consider subscribing to be notified when new content is available. The Iron Workshop lives and thrives thanks to the continued support of my Patreons. If you're willing and able, you can support me on Patreon for just $1 and get access to exclusive and early content. See you around.